Hello, welcome to the joy of d3.js, the commit by commit guide of building hand-sourcing gapminder data visualization. This is gapminder in d3.js. So who's hand-sourcing? Hand-sourcing is almost like an idol in the statistic and the data visualization world. He gave a talk at TED and also presented in BBC program called The Joy of Stats, this one. Okay. And the d3.js is a JavaScript library for manipulating document based on data. It's more than just a charting library though. During the keynote of Open Knowledge Festival 2012, Hans Rosling regarded d3.js and its author Mike Bostock very highly and said, the bubble chart that took my son one year and a half, so this one, now, you can do it in just one evening, which is this one, which Mike Bostock made. And Hans even said that you learn JavaScript and you learn how to use d3.js and you will have work in the future. That's very interesting. And I think it's probably true for someone like Mike Bostock because he knows library inside out. So this is a charting Mike made back in March 2012. And this one shows, so the vertical axis shows the average life expectancy, and the horizontal axis shows the income per capita, and the size of the bubble shows the population of each country. So each bubble is colored depending on its region. And the chart anime between 1800 to 2009, and you can just go back and forth through like hovering the years, and that's the data visualization. And I look into his source code. You can actually see the source code from here, and it's packed with like interesting techniques, though some of them are a bit too advanced for beginners. So I created a subset of his visualization with a bit of twist. So let's see how it looks like. So this very simple. And in this chart, the bubble circle is big one. Blue is Japan. And orange is United Kingdom. And if I refresh this, you can see the Japanese life expectancy suffered due to the World War II around 1943, but caught up rapidly in the mid 70s, then kind of moved in the same way with UK through the rest of the year. And also as an added bonus, clicking the map button transition, scatter plot into a map layer. This is what we're trying to create through this tutorial, okay? And so the topics. This basic visualization uses some important NPI of d3.js such as like selection, transition, scaling, working with array, loading external resources, and geography. And also there are some, I'll cover some pattern which is quite famous in d3.js world, like syncing with joins or object constancy. Okay. And while I developed this code, so I started by drawing just simple circles, then like make them move a bit. So let's check this, move a bit, and then like changing the colors, and eventually, yeah, and also adding scales, then eventually move into this animation. And then I'll go literally through like commit by commit. So like if you're interested actually playing with it, you can do git checkout and put this SHA number. Or also like I have a section called playground where like I put some sort of snippet into tributary, which is made by Ian Johnson. This is very good like interactive editor. So like I'll cover like one specific part of the d3.js techniques. So that's how we do the tutorial. So let's start.